Also, this is my first collective experience, so. The name of the poem is 10 Things That Keep Me Up At Night. 10 things that keep me up at night. 1, conversations that have only happened in my head and reacting to what I assume the other person would have said. 2, the monsters that haunt me in my sleepless hours that take the form of shadows on ceilings and skeletons and closets and memories of a broken relationship I can't seem to forget. 3, my grandfather's sleep talking. The way he is so sure someone is listening. Well, I'm not sure anyone is listening, even when I can feel people's presence like the gaze of God. 4, God and howling dogs and whistling winds and racing thoughts and stolen glances. 5, essays I should have done 10 hours ago. But I was too busy trying to see if I could prop up 2 spoons together and see if the tension would keep them together. 6, wondering if there was too much tension between us to hold ourselves together. 7, trying to see what time it is when I fall asleep, keeping myself awake for no reason other than trying to find the bridge between now and 8, tomorrow, a tomorrow full of things I am supposed to do and probably don't, of things I am supposed to say and probably won't. 9, the moon, how its borrowed radiance looks into my soul the same way he looked into my eyes, the same way he creeps into my midnight thoughts, unapologetic and beautiful. Reminds me of things I will never understand, like how leaves know how to move on at the end of each season. How the fuck am I supposed to know how to move on? Reminds me of 10, him, and how I will never truly understand us, of forevers that weren't meant to be and forevers we shared in the space of seconds. How he spoke to me like God speaks in whistling winds. The conversations he and I only had in my head and reacting to the things I wish he had said. To the things he did say and I didn't listen. To the things I should have told him I heard, but the words wouldn't make it past my stupid, stubborn mouth. The last time he said, I love you, and the first time he said my name.
Wow.